bridging past and present. Connecting Texas communities. Spanning the distance between nations. Texas Bridges Connect. Remarkably, some of our earliest bridges are still in service. The Regency Suspension Bridge, built in 1939. The Washington Avenue Bridge, built in 1902. The Rio Hondo Lift Bridge, built in 1953, the last lift bridge in Texas. Yet others have begun second lives of service as trails and pathways for Texas communities. Their fundamental purpose of providing passage unaffected by a new setting. Craftsmen built these early structures, sometimes by hand, but always with skill and artistry. Craftsmen still design and build the bridges we use today. They are uniquely diverse, like the imaginative men and women who create them. But we also care for our bridges, tend them, and assure their safety for Texans. That is our TxDOT legacy. That is our challenge. Over 53,000 bridges, that's more than any other state. But then again, our bridges are the safest in the nation. Keeping our Texas bridges safe for the traveling public is our top priority, and it all begins with design. Designing bridge rails, to be specific. Partnering with researchers at TTI, TxDOT engineers have recently developed and tested a safer, stronger, and more economical bridge rail. Replacing the current Texas Classic Rail is the culmination of years of research and study. This bridge rail will save money, ease installation, and more importantly, save lives. As a national leader in transportation research, our investigations and research studies affect transportation and engineering nationally and internationally. TxDOT's creation, testing, and pioneering use of new materials and structures are changing the future of design and construction.
There's technologies that we use here that were developed here that are almost unique to us. The best example would be our precast concrete panels. It's a way to build bridge decks. Developed here in Texas, deployed in the 1980s, used on probably 90% of what we build. It's a very effective way to build bridges in a rapid manner and in an economical way.
Our high-quality, low-cost bridges are the best in the nation, and our safety record proves it.
Here in this bend, the Brazos River keeps moving towards our abutment.
The importance of bridges, especially to the communities they connect, cannot be understated. People feel a sense of ownership, a sense of pride in a bridge that serves their community. One way to express that civic pride is through bridge aesthetics. TxDOT designers incorporate bridge aesthetics, images that represent that sense of pride and reflect the community and surrounding areas into their bridge design. Public meetings allow citizens a chance to view the project, voice opinions, and offer ideas. The images are popular, economical additions that signify community pride.
We welcome that involvement, and we love to sit down with them and listen to what their ideas are for how they want their bridge to appear. It's a good back and forth dialogue. We're, as engineers, we share their enthusiasm for their bridge because we love bridges too. And it ends up being a win-win situation.
And if you really love bridges, you'll love the tools our designers use to illustrate them. With 3D animations and visualizations, TxDOT designers generate realistic-looking models that accurately depict the final design. As stewards of the environment, TxDOT was one of the first departments of transportation in the nation to begin designing and retrofitting bridges to accommodate roosting bats. As more natural roosts disappear and are lost to urbanization, the importance of artificial habitats increases. Construction features which benefit and attract bats can be designed with a bridge to provide valuable habitat very cost-effectively. Bridge designers working collaboratively with biologists in the Environmental Affairs Division explore solutions to make bridges more welcoming to bats. Interestingly enough, bats in general don't care for our older steel truss type bridges as roosts. They prefer concrete. Our historic bridges, however, tell the story of Texas, and we strive to preserve them. In the mid-1990s, TxDOT intensified efforts to preserve historic bridges. Because of that strategy, TxDOT has, during the past decade, restored and extended the life of many of the best examples of historic bridges in the state. Working cooperatively with bats or bulldozers to create innovative bridges is our specialty. The world's first precast network arch bridge, the West 7th Street Bridge, is just such a collaborative effort. The Texas Department of Transportation, with our private sector partners, worked together to design and create a signature structure, a gateway bridge that connects the cultural district with downtown. The two-year project is quickly nearing completion and will provide safer, improved mobility for cyclists and pedestrians, as well as motorists. The new Sylvan Avenue Bridge in Dallas is an elevated six-lane roadway with sidewalks on either shoulder. The new bridge will elevate the roadway above the floodplain. Motorists will now be able to use the bridge without the threat of floodwaters closing the road. These 150-foot, 240-ton beams allow for longer spans between columns. Fewer columns in the floodplain means less debris hitting and clinging to those columns during flooding.
Makes it interesting to come to work every morning knowing you're doing something different, something that someone's never done before, and it's something new that we get to learn.
Learning played a huge role in the construction of the Clyde Warren Park in Dallas. After all, it is the first deck park in Texas and is a park built on a bridge over a road. Blending design and functionality, TxDOT is changing minds about what makes a bridge a bridge. The Clyde Warren Park in Dallas is an impressive example of partnering within the community. The deck park is actually built on top of Spur 366. The City of Dallas, the Department of Transportation, and the Woodall Rogers Park Foundation combined forces to build the deck park. The park was completed in the fall of 2012 to the delight of the citizens of Dallas. Connecting downtown and uptown, the 5-acre park provides space for group activities, music, and entertainment. But best of all, there's plenty of room to just play.
Nobody wants to stay stuck in traffic, but hey, everybody would love to go to a park. It's just so peaceful, and it's great for people to come out and have fun and enjoy themselves, and they don't know that they're on a bridge.
But TxDOT inspectors know they're on a bridge. The Clyde Warren Park is inspected at least every 24 months, just like our other bridges. Our inspection program is rigorous and thorough. Our inspectors skilled and knowledgeable. Projects under construction are inspected every step of the way. Structural steel inspector Wade Vogus says having bridge specialists just makes sense.
Well, for starters, Texas has more bridges than any other state by twice the number. That means we have to be more skilled, more professional, more intense. I think we do a better job than any other state just because we have a very good, well-rounded bridge division with good inspectors in it and good engineers.
Dedicated, experienced inspectors, they're a source of pride within the bridge division and a valuable resource for TxDOT. Recent heightened awareness of bridge safety is quickly forgotten by drivers on I-35 this evening. But in the Waco district, bridge inspector Stan Ibarra knows just how important his job is.
We're talking about lives here. You might have your family drive over this bridge one of these days, you know?
But bridge inspections don't just happen at deck level or on dry land or even during the daytime. Starting at 5 a.m. to avoid the brutal summer heat, inspectors on the Pennybacker Bridge in Austin scale the structure from the inside, searching for potential problems. Specialized equipment like our snooper trucks allows for more access and flexibility, placing workers where they need to be. Underwater inspections play an important role in our bridge maintenance and management program. When bridge elements are continuously submerged or submerged during periods of significant flow, TxDOT divers use underwater inspection techniques and management procedures to establish their condition. Underwater material damage, deterioration, and scour-related undermining may not be apparent above water until the damage has become so severe that remedial actions are extremely expensive. Early detection of underwater distress allows implementation of cost-effective repairs. As with all TxDOT inspectors, the work at hand is serious and intense. The safety of the traveling public is at stake. Bridge inspection is a continuous process on a 2-year cycle. Inspection yields a bridge rating, which gives a snapshot view of the condition of the bridge. Helping communities improve the condition of their bridges is the goal of the Federal Highway Bridge Program. Created in 1978, the program's purpose is to increase the safety of highway bridges nationwide. The Highway Bridge Program offers funding for preventative maintenance, rehabilitation, or replacement of both on- and off-system bridges. Bridge inspections play a crucial role in the eligibility process.
We got a lot of spalling and delamination underneath the bridge. Continues all the way underneath the deck.
James Paul inspects bridges in all 11 counties of the Yoakum District, teaming up with county commissioners to complete the eligibility requirements and help guide community leaders throughout the funding process. Working cooperatively towards a common goal has greatly improved bridge safety in the Yoakum District. Even safe bridges have a lifespan, but even when a bridge has reached the end of its useful life as a roadway, it still has potential. Pedestrian walkways fulfill that potential and provide yet another avenue to preserve our transportation history. Reusing bridges, recreating them as walkways and trails, extends their use, saving money while preserving engineering history along the way. Sometimes, recycling is the answer to the question, what now? Beams from bridge demolition projects create artificial reefs that become critical habitat for reef-dwelling marine life attracted to underwater structures. This new concentration of marine life, in turn, attracts scuba divers and fishermen. Concrete is an excellent reef material because it lasts longer than metal ships and rigs, which start to rust and crumble after 50 years. At some point, however, a bridge must be taken down. It's an explosive situation. The US 281 bridge over Lake Marble Falls was demolished on March 17, 2013. After 80 years of service, the bridge was part of the community, the gateway to Marble Falls. But as the area developed and grew, the old bridge became inadequate and the need for a new bridge emerged. Steel from the bridge implosion was transformed into art. It was distributed to civic groups and the Marble Falls Chamber of Commerce. The chamber commissioned a sculpture to be built with the steel recovered from the lake bed. Father Jairo Lopez, a local priest and prominent mosaic sculptor, accepted the commission. The unveiling ceremony was held in August in front of the new visitor center, just a stone's throw from the new bridge. TxDOT Craftsmen will continue to build safe, innovative bridges for Texans. The lure of bridge building is strong. The need to connect, vital. The extraordinary elegance of the Hartman Bridge. The soaring spans of the Rainbow Bridge. The simple efficiency of the Piano Bridge. Our Texas bridges. Created with inspiration. Designed with vision. Constructed to serve. Texas bridges connect us.